Jai Shri Mataji. Good morning, everyone. Let's collectively bow down, do a namaskara to Shri Mataji, raise our kundalinis and put a bandhan. Let's keep both of our hands on Mother Earth and say four mantras to Sri Ganesha. Om Tvameva Saksha Sri Ganesha Saksha Sri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha Om Tvameva Saksha Shri Ganesha Saksha Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha Om Tvameva Saksha Shri Ganesha Saksha Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha Om Tvameva Saksha Shri Ganesha Saksha Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha Shri Mataji, please bless us with the innocence of Lord Ganesha. Please make us pure, chaste, and innocent like Sri Ganesha. Shri Mataji, please bestow upon us the qualities of chastity, and please make us pure and wise. Mataji, please keep us all connected to Mother Earth, and please give us the grounding and the magnetism that's required to ascend further and further up. Mother, please protect our purity, innocence, and chastity, and give us the qualities of Sri Ganesha. We will take one mantra to Sri Adi Bhumi Devi. Om Tvamev Sakshat Shri Adi Bhumi Devi Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo. Just observe the silence for a few minutes. Let's bring both of our hands back into our lap. Raise a few strands of Kundalini from the base of our spine onto the Sahasrara. Shrimataji, please give us balance. And please establish our attention, our chitta in the present. Mother, please give us the state and the knowledge so our attention is always on your holy lotus feet. No matter what work we do, please allow our attention to always be at your holy lotus feet. We will now listen to a talk given by Shri Mataji in 1981. The title of the talk is Open Your Heart.
So to love God is even more difficult. Without seeing Him, without knowing Him, without knowing His bounties, without getting realization, it is very difficult. But today that is not the case. But still you have to have no fear in your mind. Trust. You trust yourself and trust others. First of all, try to trust yourself. If you have made mistakes, you have to say, yes, I have made mistakes, all right. So what? Trust yourself that you can correct yourself also. Trusting doesn't mean blind ego trip. It does not mean that. Trust means that, yes, I can correct myself. I can improve. I can do better. Some people think that if you trust yourself, then you should never confess anything that you have done. That you should never say that it was wrong and I can correct. This is a wrong idea. You have to trust yourself by saying that yes, I have done mistakes. I have been doing wrong. I have been faltering, but I can correct. I have that strength within me. I can rise above all these things. I have that thing within me which I can use to my advantage. Trust yourself. Trust that you are realized. Trust that God loves you, that He has chosen you to be His instrument. Love yourself. You are unique. no doubt. As it is, human beings, every individual is an unique person. But after realization, they are definitely a unique person. It never means ego trip. One has to use discretion about understanding. It never means ego trip. If you cannot correct yourself, you are not master of yourself. Yes, you are not perfect. You are unique, but you are not perfect. You have to perfect yourself. These words can be very confusing. When I say you are unique, immediately you think you are perfect. These are two words, unique and perfect. Somebody can be unique, but he can have imperfections. So you have to perfect yourself. And trust in yourself that you can perfect yourself through your Kundalini awakening, clearing your chakras, by understanding yourself, you can perfect yourself. You have to perfect. I have so many ways I tell you. Directly, sometimes indirectly, through friends, somehow point out that this is the problem. You should think that I am within you. I am that part within you which is discretion. When you do not understand your own discretion, I try to give you the direction, by this way or that way. But people feel hurt, people feel bad, or some of them accept it. If you are seekers and if you are ascending, you are definitely unique, but specially blessed, and you have to pay special attention to yourself. You can't afford to play with yourself. So you have to discriminate between ego or ego trips, as they call it, and ascent. Ego trips bring you back with the worst hurting. It would be something like throwing you in the air and again you come back with a bump and break one of your necks or something like that. That's what ego trip is. But ascent is where you really rise above. Not only that you rise, but with you, you make others rise. In your ascent, you develop tremendous powers. The higher you ascend, the better it is. But not by understanding that I am perfect, you can ascend. Never so. There's a story of a teacher and his student. The teacher was very kind to the student when he would come and show him his creations. He was very kind to him. And every time he would say that I have done this good and this is the thing that I have not been able to do. So will you please tell me how to correct it? And the teacher would say, yes, good. You better correct this part. Then do this. Now one day the student came and said, now this is perfect. He said, you are no more student now. So he said, no more, you are not to come to me anymore. There was another student who was coming every day and correcting himself. And he told to his teacher that today I think I can teach others, but not yet perfect. He said, all right, you go and teach. student who came, and he was always trying to see what was the mistake and how he has to correct, and how he worked very hard, very assiduous, very hard working. And he came to his teacher one day and he said, "Sir, I will not trouble you anymore now." He said, "True, now you take my seat." That is what one has to understand. You ascend, you will become humbler. It is just the other way around, people understand. You see, when they ascend, they think we have achieved some special powers. I don't know, suddenly self-certification starts, you see. I'm very good in spirituality, I'm very high up and all that. The self-certificate starts. And then it can reach such a point that suddenly you found you are on the earth again. This kind of thing is not the way it works. Actually, the people who ascend, there are certain qualities that show on them. The first thing is your collectivity. How collective you are. With how many people you can carry on. At how many things you can laugh. That is one of the biggest qualities. The second quality is that how much you accept another's domination who cuts down your collectivity. You must have your personality separate from everyone. If you allow others to cut your personality, say for example, there's a boss and you are the employee, and the boss is not realized soul and you are a realized soul. Or maybe both are realized souls. Take it like that. And one of them is ascending. Then he becomes humbler, he becomes better, there are congenial relationships. But to a point, he will never compromise with his boss when it comes to his ascent, to his collectivity, to his giving, to his doing things for others. On that point, he'll never have any domination, because how much you feel responsible about yourself is the second one. How much you are responsible to be a cell in the heart. Any cell that fails, fails the heart. Every cell in the heart has to be extremely sensitive and extremely obedient to the self, to the spirit. It has to activate, work harder when there is need, there are emergency. That it enjoys the most. And no impurity should be allowed. The third point. As I told you, first is collectivity, secondly your responsibility. And third point is purity. Purity of your own heart, first of all. Of your own heart, about sincerity, cunningness. As I am saying this, you will be realizing that all Englishmen believe in the contrary nowadays, not olden times, but nowadays. Clean heart, transparent, open heart, trust others. Talk to everyone with an open heart. Trust others. Why do you doubt? if you do not doubt yourself, you will not doubt others. What are they going to take away from you? What have you got? Nobody can take away your nose, eyes, nothing. It's all quite intact. It's all nicely glued down. So nothing is going to disappear. What are they going to hurt to a person who is a realized soul? If your heart is clean, you can see the other person clearly through and through. Innocence is such a powerful thing, that even a glance is sufficient to kill a satan. Purity of heart. Actually, when the heart becomes impure, the impurity flows down to other places. It is not the other way around. It is from the heart. Many people believe that it's the body that becomes impure. I think it is the heart which becomes really impure, and then it starts trickling down to the body, and then it is residual there, it settles down there. So have a clean, open heart like a child's heart. Open heart. What is there to be afraid of anyone? What is there not to trust anyone? What is there to be angry with anyone? Talk to everyone, shake hands with everyone. Be nice to everyone. On the way you find somebody's difficulty, give him a hand. If somebody cannot sit properly or has a problem, you try to remove the problem. If the person cannot stand, give the place. Try to give from your clean heart. If your heart is not clean, it can never give. Now, how do you clean the heart? The subject which Felicity wanted me to discuss is how to clean the heart. There's no broom available for that in the supermarket. There are no fairy liquids or anything to wash it down. Allow your heart to be drenched in your mother's love. Just allow. See how much she loves you. I trust you. People laugh at me sometimes. Some of these saints who are supposed to be very great people, they can't understand how I trust you. They say that, oh, these are all lost races. These are horrible people. How do you trust them? They are not sannyasis. They are not sadhus. They are nothing. They are ordinary people. For them, I mean, your value is nothing. If you go to them, they will make you stand on your head for 3 months. For 3 years, they may hang you on a well. I don't know what they will do to test you. But I trusted you the day I saw you. The day you came to me, I trusted you. Now, I've worked on you from the very first day. Knowing what you are, but I trust your spirit that it would shine. In the same way, trust. We laugh at others. I've seen such yogis laugh at others, make fun of them when they come to. Trust them. When you will trust them, you will respect them also. So you have to believe in yourself and enjoy the way gently you are sweeping into the current of your mother's love. Just enjoy that. Like a flower that falls into the current and flows and enjoys all the beauties of that current. In the same way, you should enjoy. When that enjoyment comes into you, you will start trusting and trust your mother. I try many things to correct you, but trust in one thing, that whatever I try for you or do anything I may do for you, it is just to clean you. That's my job. May sometimes you might feel I'm publicly saying things for you. Maybe your images are being ruined by that, or whatever you may think. That's not the way. Is for your hita, is for the well-being of your spirit. And that is the most difficult job. With all this, trust in your heart. First trust yourself, trust others, others are yogis. Love thy neighbor as thyself. Who is your neighbor? He's a subject. Stand by. And trust your mother. As I have trusted you, you have to trust me. And it will work out. Open your heart to this trust. You should not worry whether it would be protocolish all right or not, whether it would be absolutely respectable or not, because heart knows. Whatever your heart will do in its genuine form will be respected, because there resides your spirit which manifests. That will look after. By outer forms, whatever you try, it's not going to work. It is that trust in your loving heart that is good. It doesn't matter. You see, today she brought some flowers. There were some supposed to be weeds, according to her. She went to the station and then she was taking some flowers out. And the station master and his wife were very sweet. And they said, oh, go ahead, they are only weeds, you can have them. And they are so fragrant, one of the most fragrant flowers I have ever seen. They are just weeds. They do not conform to any formal flowers. But just few flowers attached to other flowers were most fragrant. Love gives all the sophistication and the fragrance and all the breeding that is required. Not talking of love, but really loving is the way. It's most enjoyable.
Thank you, Mother. What a wonderful year of 2021. Thank you for all your blessings. For all the opportunities of growth. And thank you for everything, Mother. Mother, please make us your good instruments so we are able to spread your love in this wonderful world of yours, in this new year as well. And let us grow further and further in our ascent, and please give us space in your holy lotus feet. Cheshire Mataji. Thank you, Mother, for everything. Let's say the three great mantras. Om Tvamev Sakshat Shri Mahalakshmi Mahasaraswati Mahakali Trigunatmika Kundalini Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha Om Tvamev Sakshat Shri Kalki Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha Om Tvamev Sakshat Shri Kalki Sakshat Shri Sahasrar Swami Moksha Pradayini Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha Bolo Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Ji Ki Jai. Jai Shri Mataji. Let's collectively bow down to Shri Mataji's holy lotus feet. Raise our kundalini and put on bandhan. thank you everyone for joining this morning, and wish you all a very happy new year. Thank you everyone for being with us in this wonderful year, and for being such wonderful divine instruments of Shri Mataji. We hope all of you will continue to spread the love given by Shri Mataji in various forms, and continue to make this place a beautiful and loving world as Mother has envisioned. So thank you to all the wonderful yogis of this world. Have a happy and prosperous new year, everyone. And please feel free to continue to meditate. We'll keep the music running for a few more minutes. Jai Shri Mataji. Jai Shri Mataji, have a lovely day ahead.